Hi, everybody. Thank you so much for tuning in. I'm really excited today. We've got a special guest from the Netherlands. Nadia is a photographer in portraits. I think you do weddings and other stuff as well. We'll learn more about what Nadia shoots. But today, the things that I'm excited to talk about is having a good workflow. There's a lot of talk today about studio management. There's a lot of software out there that we've been talking about on the blog. But I want to get into the nuts and bolts first about why take the time to have a workflow. A lot of us, I know myself included, we like to, I think, use the excuse as we're creatives and therefore I'm just unorganized. That's just the way it is. And luckily, there's hope for all of us. I was the most disorganized person and I've learned how to add structure to my life and gotten my life back, thankfully, from the chaos. In today's episode, we're going to be hearing how Nadia has gone through this journey as well, from the chaos and the challenges and the sleepless nights where we're stressing about, am I forgetting something? Do I have a wedding this weekend or not? And what are all the things I have to get done to pull this off? So Nadia, welcome to the show. How are you doing today?
Thank you so much, Nate. I'm really fine. I'm very excited to be here.
Good, good. Thank you. So let's jump right in. What kind of photography do you shoot and how long have you been shooting?
Basically, my first wedding I shot in 2009, and so weddings are my core business. And apart from that, I do photo shoots with primarily people who are in love. And I just really love the emotion and the the special feelings of these of these days. So
awesome, awesome, very cool. Kudos to you. Out of all the different styles of portrait photography, weddings is one I don't have the guts to pull off. I feel like it requires a special talent and guts, I think, for the high pressures of somebody's special wedding.
Yeah, I was really nervous the first time I did a wedding, but I actually said no like three times the first time someone asked me to shoot her wedding.
Yeah,
but she insisted, so yeah, here I was.
Well, I'm glad she did. That's awesome. So what percentage of your time do you run your photography business, and what other, do you have a day job as well?
No, I maybe I should have a day job because I graduated as a medical doctor 2.5 years ago. But basically, like right after I graduated, things went really out of hand with photography.
Yeah.
So it's been my full-time job since then. Wow. And I actually never planned to have this full-time period of photography extend for such a long time, but it's just awesome, and I really like it.
Congratulations, that's fantastic. I think you're the first person I've met that has finished medical school to become a photographer, a wedding photographer. Congratulations, that's so cool.
Thank you. Yeah. Okay. And I will start working as a doctor at the end of this year as well. So I'll try to combine.
Try to do both. Oh, that'll be interesting. I think you absolutely then need this, a good structure, a good workflow to keep,
definitely,
to be able to balance that many things. So I'm also curious, this is just selfishly, what's the photography portrait market like in the Netherlands? Have you heard, are there certain things that are different for you guys versus how things are, trends happening in the US?
Yeah, I think the first thing that comes to my mind is that we don't really have a such thing as senior portraits.
Mm-hmm.
So we don't have it at all. And I think for the rest, I think it's comparable.
Mm-hmm.
People who are in love, they always like to have photographs of themselves taken, and it gives just so much fun and bliss. So yeah, I think that's the same.
Awesome.
And what I hear from my colleagues is that they sometimes do find it hard to build a sustainable business, but yeah, it's nothing that I have really experienced, luckily.
Good for you. Yeah, it sounds like demand was already grew very quickly, so much though that you didn't even have to get the day job. So give me an idea of how many weddings are you shooting on average per year right now?
About 20 to 25 per year.
Good. Wow, that's a lot.
Yeah.
Do you typically have a second shooter, or are you working by yourself?
No, I usually work by myself.
Mm-hmm.
Unless a wedding is very big, like say 250 people or more, I don't really need a photographer, a second shooter, I think. I don't really miss it. So I think I'm doing just fine on my own.
Perfect.
It just, yeah.
It works for you. That's cool. So give me a snapshot of the growth and how quickly it was. So this in the last year, you're on average 20 to 30 weddings. What have your prices been, and what are your average prices now, and how did those grow with the number of weddings you did?
Well, I've had a very interesting development, I think, in terms of pricing. I think I started, oh, well, my first wedding I did for 500 euros, which is how many dollars? Let me see.
About 1,000, yeah.
Yeah, no, it's $640.
Oh,
So
okay.
it was my first wedding.
Yeah.
Yeah,
Okay,
12
wow.
hours. And, but then, well, I think I increased my prices pretty quickly until it was like I doubled it within a year. I'm $2,000 for 6 hours. And it's funny because in between these, let me think, how shall I explain this? I've had a period in which I only wanted to be there for 9 hours or more, or even I did an experiment with a full day package. But the funny thing is, like, or well, it wasn't actually that funny because I felt that I lost the clients that I wanted. And the clients that I wanted were the people who were creative, not very traditional, maybe sometimes young, sometimes around 30, but like people who don't necessarily have a really good job or, very rich parents, but people who are just plain fun. That's what I really like. And well, I figured that in this time when I had this large package, so to say, so the full day coverage, some people came and talked to me, and we had really good talks, and it was just so much fun. And then in the end, they ended up declining me because of the budget. And I just felt so sorry for myself for missing these people, so I decided to be a bit more low key in terms of pricing, and to start again at 6 hours, and then increase. People can decide according to their budget what for how long they want to hire me.
That's really cool. There's a really important takeaway here that I think you approached it really maturely. I think so many times I hear this challenge of, I hate saying no to, especially as we grow our businesses, a lot of us grow through word of mouth referrals, right? And so you start getting these referrals from past clients, and then that's in conflict to doubling your rates, because all of a sudden the friend who referred you is like, "What? I only paid this, and she wants to charge you this?" It's that's definitely a challenge that photographers have to overcome. But I love that your approach was not to just stay with your rates too low, but to think about it and respect your own time, and do so in a creative way so that you still got to work with the clients you really enjoyed working with.
Yeah,
So, and
exactly.
that's worked out okay so far.
Yeah, it does. But I must say that like there has been some sort of inner conflict because like the full day package, it was really something that I was standing for because I really want to tell the story from the beginning of the day, like from the moment that the bride gets out of her bed or even before until the party ends and people are totally wasted. Like these are the times that I love the most. It's just fun and everyone is laughing and having a good time. And so that's it, I must say it wasn't some sort of a big decision for me to go back to the 6 hour thing. But for me, having cool clients who really love my photography and sometimes they want to save up to be able to hire me. These are the people I really love to work with, and that's what
That's what matters at the end of the day. That's really cool.
exactly.
Have you noticed in offering and just keeping the door open with that lower like starting price, do you have people that does that help you kind of bridge the gap and where they start and have the conversation with you and then realize later that, you know what, this really is important. We do want full day coverage, even though it's extending out of our budget.
Yep, definitely.
Good for you. That's awesome. I think that more and more weddings are expensive, yes. And I think trends that are happening around the world is that people are really starting to, especially the ones who are paying for their wedding on their own now. I think that's really starting to increase as people are waiting longer to get married, and they're paying for more of the wedding on their own. They've got maybe they already have a mortgage, or they want to buy a house, and they see the silliness of spending a house payment on or a whole house on a wedding day. But But as some of the things get taken off the budget, I think that photography is one that is staying and possibly growing because people realize that it really is one of the most important parts of their day. Otherwise, it really only lasts, it's a blur. Everybody says, if there's one common thing I hear people explain about their wedding day, is that it was a blur. And thank God I have the pictures to remember every moment. So.
Yeah, I think so too. And also, what I really think that we as photographers benefit from is the fact that everyone loves photography nowadays. Everyone has got at least an iPhone and maybe even a DSLR. So they really understand the value of photography, and I think that helps us a lot.
Yeah, for sure. Well, that was a really fun tangent. Okay, so I love learning about new businesses and how you've grown yours. Congratulations on that. So let's talk about workflow. So through this journey of growing your own business, you just kind of, as we were talking in the pre-show, just kind of went at it, not really anticipating how quickly you're going to grow and where exactly your business fit, and you didn't have a very well-defined workflow. So what were some of the challenges and stresses involved with figuring that out?
Yeah, well, it was really interesting because, yeah, just like you mentioned, I was really overwhelmed by the number of assignments that I got, and it just hit me. I never really expected it to go like this, and it made me grateful, of course, in the first place, and in the same time, so stressed because I was like, oh, how am I gonna pull this off? And all these people and their names and like the points in time in which I have to finish all these deadlines and all that. So it really caused me a great deal of stress to keep everything on track.
So yeah, I can relate to that for sure. And I think we all it's as creatives, it's hard to say no, right? We love it's so flattering when people want to hire us to do our work. And it's very difficult to say no. And it's very rewarding when people are the client list is growing. Give me some specifics if you can think of any. Like what was some of the lower points where you were like, okay, this really sucks. I've got to do something to fix it.
I think that was last winter when I really sometimes woke up at 4 o'clock in the night and then my to-do list started
It's like running through your mind.
running through my mind, and it just drove me crazy. And I really, honestly, I noticed that I was not as relaxed as I used to be. And I noticed that I worried much more about my work than I was supposed to and that I wanted to. So that was the point in which I realized that I really have to undertake action because, well, my business is probably only gonna grow if I don't, if I don't stop it myself, and I don't want to. That was the point in which I realized that I really had to do something to have more structure, because I think you can do a lot, but only if you know what your next step is gonna be, when it needs to be finished, and how to, how to keep track of all these loose tasks that you have to do. And of course, you want to keep your clients happy. So yeah, that's really, I think it's an important, that's an
So you said so many good things right there. I want to pull apart. So one, you can take on a lot, but as long as you know what the next step is, because a lot of detail, it's the devil's in the details. And I think first of all, I want to make sure we're spending some time on just the attitude and the reason why we do photography and the joy of doing the work we do can be so rewarding to get paid to do your art, right? But then all of a sudden we find ourselves in this catch 22 of now it's this job that's stressing us out and keeping us up at night and pulling us away from our other relationships, our social life, our family life. And it can I hear this story where we did actually did a survey of our users recently, and work-life balance was one of the top challenges photographers said they struggle with. And I think this goes beyond just photography. I think it's something that's happening across a lot of professions where especially when you run your own business, it's very difficult to turn this off. But it's so important that you find a way to automate and to streamline so that we can get our sanity back. And
Definitely.
it's like, why are we working so hard anyway if we're not getting the benefits of being our own bosses, right? We're getting the flexibility and the peace of mind. So, Okay, so you realized that enough is enough. You've got to do something to fix it. What were some of the first things you started to do, and what were some solutions you saw that really caught your attention?
I did a few things. I think one of the most important things in my business that I improved was that I started using Shootzilla, which is a task manager, so to say, for professional photographers to keep track of all their assignments and so that you know exactly what needs to be finished on what date, and it's a really smooth system. So that's one thing. Second thing is I hired an assistant.
Oh, go awesome.
To help me with the bulk of culling and the bulk of editing. So I really still have the final, I make the final decisions because I think it's really important for me to, you know, put my signature on the photographs. And it's as well in the selection of the pictures as in the editing. So run over everything in the end. But it really takes away a lot of stress. Because she just re reduces the bulk of the work.
Yeah, so okay, another again really cool two takeaways. So one is everybody says you've got to delegate, right? When you're too busy, we can't do it all. You've got to start delegating. And obviously as photographers, culling and editing is one of the first things people talk about delegating. Was that hard to do? Did you feel like you were giving up control?
Yes, I felt like I gave my baby to someone else and I was like, you know, have fun. And it's really difficult because I think one of the main problems or challenges in this business is the fact that everything, this work is so personal, at least to me. Like I put so much heart and soul in what I'm doing. So it makes you really vulnerable because you feel like you're the only one who can do it. And it should be really good. Because I'm not gonna give away something crappy of myself, you know? And I think it's really interesting. It's also very funny to reflect on this and to realize how
So
you
what
think.
would so having going through this, what are some of the key takeaways? I think let's start with what advice would you give a photographer in your shoes back then, making that first step? What were some things you learned in finding the right person and in gradually giving that responsibility to them?
There was this girl who I knew she was talented. I've been following for a long time, but she hasn't had her business for a long time, so it's not yet her day job. So she did have some time left for me to to squeeze me in. It was someone that I knew already, and I thought she was a pleasant person to work with, someone who understands my style and who can really, you know, be a part of me, so to say. And that was a very important thing, and I trusted her right away, especially when we first went through the training period. I really felt like she really picked up the things that I said, the feedback that I gave her, and that was really important for me to have enough trust in her to really, give her my baby and say,
Right,
like,
right.
have it for
So
your
when you
business.
first, that very first wedding you had her work on, were you planning, did you still feel like you had to do the bulk of the work and just walked her through your style as you did it? Or did you, were you so busy that you were like, okay, this wedding, go for it and see what you do?
No. I really believe in good education, and I really took the time to tell her what are the grounds on which I base my decisions. So when you're culling, as well as when you're editing, look at these things and, you know, pay attention to this detail. And then, we started. I culled and edited a wedding when she was looking. I think maybe we did another one like this. Then she did the work and I looked and I gave her feedback. And then she did one on her own. And then later we talked it through. So that was really the process.
That's awesome. That's really valuable. Good for you. What were some of the, was there any con like what were there any parts where you were like, oh, maybe this isn't a good fit, or did it feel like a good fit right away?
It felt like a good fit.
Yeah, good for
I
you.
didn't have any doubts about it.
Yeah, you've got to address that right away. Well, that's fantastic. So then the other piece is just organizing all of the things you have to do. I think that so much of running a business means we do everything. We have to be marketing, legal, sales, bookkeeping. Everything has to go through you, right? Even as we start to delegate, you still have to be the one that sets. I think that hiring somebody to do something is so much harder to do if you don't have the process you want to do, or the process you're already doing yourself documented somehow. If it's all in your head, it just perpetuates this, oh, I can't give this to anybody because I don't even know where to start or where to tell them what to do. And just forcing ourselves to document and to explain the criteria and how you do your business, that's invaluable.
Yeah, and you have to know the things that you base your decisions on, and that's also part that I think it may be hard for some people to realize why they pick this photograph and not the other one, or why they do this edit. And sometimes it's just a feeling, and then you have to dive into it and think like, well, what is this feeling based on?
Oh, really good feedback. Okay. All right. So then when you came across Shootzilla, what was your first impression? Were you already saying, I'm realizing I've got to start doing some better workflow management? Were you doing like a big written board? What were some of the tools you were already starting to use when you first came across Shootzilla?
I think I wrote a Word document already with all the steps just for myself, because I wanted to make a big sheet of paper and write all the names of my couples, and then
All the
like
things you have to do,
check all
yep.
the yeah.
Yep.
But then Shootzilla came across, and my Word document helped me out on obviously to put all the phases of my workflow into Shootzilla.
Yeah.
But well, honestly, the first time I heard about Shootzilla, I was really interested, so I subscribed, and then I was just way too busy to really put some time and effort into it to make it work.
Okay.
And that was something that I honestly put it aside for maybe 3 months or maybe more, until I realized that I really needed it. And then it just needs a little bit of time to set it up well, and then you can just work like crazy with it.
Yeah, that's awesome. What advice would you give to somebody who's considering start, like if they're on the fence, is what's what when I think that one thing I heard from you is the import like you jumped in, you saw the need, but you weren't really feeling the pain hard enough yet. And then it took about 3 months, you're like, okay, enough is enough. I need to just figure this out.
I think that I did feel the pain already, but I was procrastinating, just like we all
Yeah,
do.
exactly. Yep.
And so, my piece of advice would just be, get out of that chair and do it, because it's gonna give you so much back for for the time that you invest in it. And I think this work is really, well, it is sort of complex. You have a lot of different tasks in that need to be finished in a lot of different dates, and you just cannot do it by yourself. It's nice to think of yourself as being capable of anything, but you are not.
No.
So if you can just delegate your like part of your brain load, or how do you say
Is that
this?
your cognitive load or yeah, totally. Yes.
So a piece of software, just do it. I mean,
Yes.
it's just really a no-brainer.
Oh, good. Yeah. I think I like to think about this in there's certain things that as creatives, as artists, as business owners, that I think there's a human element that will never go away, right? The computers can't do everything. There's a part that we need to hold on to and where we will always add value. But if we get overwhelmed and oftentimes we race right up into our total capacity, it starts to impact our ability to do those most human things, right? And being present with our customers. And instead of worrying about something we're forgetting, we can actually show up to a shoot like 100% on and 100% present there for the customer. What requires us to get our stuff together. And I think there's on the other side, there's certain tasks, certain things that computers do really, really well. Those are like a lot of repetitive things that don't require a lot of artistic critique is doing the same thing over and over and over again. And computers are also really good at remembering things forever. Like computers don't forget, right? So it's leveraging that asset in the best breakdown of your business is huge. So now that you've been using it for a while, what are some of the advantages you've noticed in your own personal life and also in how it's helped you grow your business as well?
How it has helped me in my personal life. Well, it's really easy. It just eliminates the chaos out of my mind. Yeah, the like before I started using Shootzilla, like all these names of all the couples were just tumbling around, and I was like, oh, what do I need to do next? And I just don't know, and I need to find it out again. And then, like, my 20 to-do lists were shattered all over the room. It just drove me crazy. And now I think it's really reassuring to know that everything is in one place. I just need to go there, look at it, what's for today, and then I just do it. And it's very simple. And so it just frees up some space in my mind to be more creative, to be more, well, to think better about what I want with my business, what I want for my future, how am I going to accomplish that. So yeah, it's for me a big relief.
That's awesome to hear. So I can relate to similar things where if you're just stuck in like reactionary mode, it feels like you're like always so busy. It's like, what do I do? Oh, I gotta do this. That's right. I just remembered. I gotta do this. Oh, I just gotta do this. And we get stuck thinking really small about like just minute to minute, maybe day to day. Whereas when you start to manage all of the things on your plate, it lets you zoom up higher and think about your own business as like a CEO and a very strategic mind. Like, okay, what are some of the strategic things I can be doing in my business so that I enjoy my work better, so that I can grow my business and still have time,
And
right?
I totally love it. And it's really exactly because of this, what you're saying, that I'm gonna start giving workshops. And I've wanted to do workshops for a really long time, and I just never got to it. And then, well, actually today I wrote my first, like the first page on my website to describe all the workshops that I'm gonna give, and I'm super excited to do it. And I'm pretty confident that I would have never done, well, I would have never been able to do this when I was still running around like, chaos on two legs.
That's so cool. I love hearing those stories. Oh, congratulations on taking those first steps and making the time. I think that one of the things my wife and I like to talk about is there's urgent things that are urgent, and there's things that are important. And so often we end up ignoring the important things in our life and in our business because our lives are too full of the things that are urgent. And we've got to react to them right away. And it just isn't the best use of our creative talents when we're doing even the things that you would eventually do. They just don't get done as well or as clean or as rewarding when we're doing them out of like frenzy. Where now we can do a lot of the same tasks, but it's from a grounded place. So really cool. I wish there was a Shootzilla for running sticky albums. Just tell me everything one step by step what I should be doing. I'll wrap up with, I think I might post this video. One of my favorite talks. Have you ever seen the TED talk by a guy named Daniel Pink? He wrote the book Drive, which is all about the things that motivate people. It have really the what we think about used to motivate people, like they call it carrot and stick. Like, and if you're running a business, people are motivated by more money or incentives or prizes, or the fear of punishment, like they're gonna get fired or scolded for not doing your job well. But everybody knows now that just doesn't work, especially doing the kinds of work that we do today. And instead, what's more important is having a sense of autonomy and like you being able to decide how you want to run your day, which I think is a huge factor in the entrepreneurs I meet and the photographers I meet in deciding to do their own business. Is you get that control, you're your own boss. The opportunity to be able to master something, to really learn and grow your talents is very rewarding. And then finally, an opportunity to do work on something with a greater purpose, something that's bigger than ourselves. And I think there's so many threads that connect to photography, and like being able to capture somebody's wedding day is such a it's an amazingly important thing. So taking all of that, I do recommend the video. He explains each very well, but the thing I find myself reflecting on is how, as a business owner now, the flip side is I feel like I have too much autonomy. It's like almost on some days I almost crave that I had a boss again. It's like, can somebody just, out of all this stuff I'm doing today, or that should on my list is so long, like somebody just tell me what I should do instead of me having to decide. And talking through this whole experience, I think that is exactly what a workflow management tool or a really good workflow and to-do list, whatever it is that you're doing, having that stuff set up so that we're not stressing ourselves out with what should I be doing today? What should I be doing right now? What's next? What's next? What's next? When you have it documented in a constructive way, it gives you that freedom back to really focus on the things you enjoy doing. So long tangent, but I really think it applies here. I recommend the video. So Nadia, thank you so much. This was so enjoyable. I really love talking to people and photographers all over the world. It was cool to get a perspective from somebody doing this all the way over in Amsterdam or nearby Amsterdam. Very cool stuff.
Thanks, Matt.
Let's see. Is there anything else you'd like to add? Any like takeaways you'd like to share with our audience? Put you on the spot.
Oh, let me think. Well, I think it's, yeah, I would just recommend to for people to get rid of the stupid stuff, like the things that you really don't like for example, thinking about your to-do list or your business administration, and really try, well, be aware of what you don't like so that you can cut back your time that you spend on these kind of things, and so you can really spend the time on what you find valuable.
Perfect. I love it. And speaking from a place of experience, so this was so fun to go on this journey with you and looking back on the journey you've gone along. Congratulations on your success.
Thanks so
I
much.
really I'll look forward to when you start putting out your workshops. Reach back out. I would love to see what you're working on, and I'm happy to promote stuff as well
Thanks
and
so
spread the
much.
word about the projects you're working on. So thanks again, and you have an awesome rest of your day.
Thank you, you too.
Cheers.